DJI Neo 2. I have been flying this around for the last week or so. I picked it up on a recent trip to Shanghai and I brought it back here to Seoul, South Korea, and I've been flying it around quite a bit for the last week or so. I took it out to the Hungang Drone Park here in the city, which is a nice big open area right next to the Han River and a great place to test it out. The very first day that I took it out, it was nice and calm. There wasn't a lot of wind. It was beautiful weather and I was able to use a lot of the features with it. I flew it with the remote, with the phone app, and then again with just the button controls that we have here on the side. And then I brought it out on another day where it was much windier and I was able to really test it out and see how it worked under a little bit more difficult settings. So I'm gonna go ahead and talk about a lot of the key features, some of the upgrades over the original Neo, the things I like, don't like, pricing, and a lot more. So we'll go ahead and get into that. Now, the first feature that I want to talk about with this drone is the obstacle avoidance detection system. This wasn't available on the original Neo. This one features a LiDAR system right here in the front. It's able to detect how far objects are away from them by using lasers to bounce it off. And then it also has these two little cameras. You can't record with these cameras, but it does detect objects. And this is for the upwards and downwards movements. And they work overall pretty well. I did have a few crashes with this indoors. The very first crash that I had, I was at my hotel in Shanghai and I didn't have any windows in my hotel room and the lighting was really not good. It was pretty dim. So what ended up happening is that it was following me around and then it just ended up flying right into the ceiling. You can see that I have a little bit of that oh crap moment right here. I kind of wrote it off as just being really bad lighting. It wasn't really that big of a deal. The next crash that I ended up having was here at my apartment in Seoul. As you can see, it's pretty good lighting, but I turned it on and then it flew right into the ceiling. I don't know if because the ceiling's white and it's pretty bright in here that it just assumed that the ceiling was the sky or something. I don't really know, but that was a little bit disappointing. Didn't really damage it, so not that big of a deal. And then the next crashes that I had, I was flying it around at the park and it went into a tree as I was doing boomerang shot. That happened twice actually. It didn't crash, but it didn't really detect the tree. So it didn't work that great, but again, it didn't crash. I was able to just bring it right back down and continue using it as intended. Most other occasions when it would detect something, it would just kind of stop and then just finish recording. So that shows that overall the obstacle detection works really well. It's just not perfect 100% of the time. I did have one more crash, but that was entirely user error. I put the drone into sports mode and I was just whipping it around the park and I kind of punched the throttle. It went straight into a fence and crashed. Thankfully, I was able to just take off right where it was. I didn't have to go out and recover the drone or anything. It does show that this drone is pretty durable. I haven't had any damage. I haven't had to replace any of these blades or anything, so I'm happy with that. It shows how durable this drone is overall. The next thing to talk about is the actual camera itself. The original Neo had a 12 megapixel camera and this one does as well. The original Neo was an aperture of f2.8 and then this one is an aperture of 2.2. So not a huge improvement, but it is a little bit better and you know it works a little bit better for lower light settings. As far as image quality is concerned though, the image quality is definitely better on here, particularly because this now features a two axis gimbal. The original Neo only had a one axis gimbal, so what it would do is would crop the image and you don't have that problem here. So without having to crop the image, you do get a better overall image quality. I'm pretty happy with it. You can see from my footage that it's not bad at all and I'm not making cinematic high quality films. I'm not making quality videos at all. So I'm pretty happy with the overall image. And considering that this drone is for people like me who pretty much make travel videos or online content, it works for what you need. The next feature I wanted to talk about was the gesture control. You can hold your hand out like this to make it lock onto you. And then from there, you can control where it is positioned. So you can raise it up, down, left, right. And then if you use both hands, you can spread your hands out to make it go further away from you. Or you can pinch your hands and bring them back in to bring the drone back towards you. You know, it's probably not great for if you're filming, but it's a lot of fun. It makes you feel like you have magical powers and it lets you reposition the drone for whatever quick shots that you may be wanting to do next. And overall, it is pretty responsive and it works most of the time. When it was windy, I had a little bit of difficulty getting it to lock onto me, but if you just mess around with it a little bit under those more difficult settings, it will eventually lock onto you and then you can control it. When it was really calm, it worked flawlessly, so I'm pretty happy with that. It also has an auto landing feature, which works most of the time. Again, when it was a little bit windy, I had no obstacles on the ground and it didn't really seem to want to land where it was supposed to. We're not gonna cancel the landing. So I mean, this is just landing by itself, which is really awesome. That being said, with the wind, we only got about 10, looks like we got 11 minutes. Are we gonna land by ourselves? How are we doing?
Low battery. Return to home promptly.
Under aircraft, unsuitable for landing. Okay. It does land by itself once the battery gets down to about 7 to 18%. You can override that if you so choose, but keep in mind that if the battery drops down to zero, your drone's just gonna... which, you know, you probably don't want to do that if you don't want to damage it. It is durable, but I wouldn't mess with that too much. Now, onto the battery life. The battery life, they claim that it lasts for about 19 minutes. I have not been able to get 19 minutes at all. Generally, I'm getting about 14 or 15 minutes, and that's pretty much under normal settings. When it was under high wind and this thing was fighting against the wind, it was closer to 10 minutes. And then when I put it into sports mode and I was just whipping it around the whole time, it was about 8 minutes. So that's not the worst. It's not as good as they claim it's gonna be, but I'm pretty happy with that. And then I have 3 batteries, so I'm able to get quite a bit of use out of it. You should be able to get 45 minutes total out of 3 batteries. And then of course you can always pick up more batteries if you so choose. I did try to let it just hover indoors without manipulating any of the controls and just let it sit there. I was hoping that I would have gotten that 19 minutes, but it ended up still being about 14 minutes. Which was a little bit surprising. For the internal storage, this has a 49 gigabyte internal storage, which is about double the 22 gigabytes that was available on the original Neo. Unfortunately, there is no expansion for an SD card, so if you wanna clear up the memory, you're gonna either need to transfer all your files over to your phone and then go back in through the app and delete it, or you know, just run out of memory. But as far as I'm concerned, that's plenty. You're not going to run through all 3 batteries and kill all of your memory. You should be able to get a full day's use of this without having to transfer those files. However, if you run through all of your batteries, you're not going to use up all the memory. I think I went through about 9 batteries with total continuous recording before I started getting to that upper limit of the storage. So as long as you transfer those files off of here and onto your phone, you shouldn't have any problems with running out of memory on here. So just be diligent with that. And hopefully whenever they come out with the Neo 3 or the Neo 4, later on down the road, they'll add an SD card expansion. As far as the controls are concerned, I picked this up with the remote control and I'm really happy that I did. It's very responsive and it's way more fun. Now, you can use the phone app, and the phone app is pretty good for changing the parameters. If you want to do the quick shot, you can change the distance from you, or if it's following you, you can change it to follow you from the front, the back, the side, high, low. But the remote is where it really shines. The app overall though is pretty good. I just wouldn't want to use the manual controls on that. The other alternative is that you can use these buttons here on the side, and they're pretty intuitive. You can just change the parameters and then you can launch it pretty easily with this button right here. Just launch it off of your hand and does whatever you have it set to. In order to turn the drone on, you'll hit here. You have the button on the battery. You just hit it once and then long hold the second time and it will turn on. And give it a second to power up. And on here, it'll tell you what mode it is in. I don't know how well you can see that on camera, but it says boomerang, 10 meters. That's the current mode that we want to select. Now, we can change the options with these buttons here. So I would hold down just on that, and I can change the parameters. So I can go from 10 meters, now it's 6 meters,
4 meters,
20 meters, etc. So we're gonna go ahead and do 6 meters, and then we'll select this button to set that parameter, and then once I am ready, it will go. So far, no problems. Let's see what we get. So hey, look, works perfectly good. Click to that.
Circle.
Rocket. So let's go ahead and do a rocket. So we have it set rocket 20 meters spin on. Again, if I want to change one of those parameters, I would just hold down on this little button right here. And so I can change it to 20 meters, 10 meters, 6 meters, 4 meters. We'll go back to 20 meters and then we'll select that.
10 meters, 6 meters, 4 meters, 20 meters.
And if I want to change the second parameter, I hold down this other button. So I have spin on, I can do spin off, spin on. Those are the only two options. So we're good on that. So now if I just want a really quick rocket shot, we'll go ahead and fire it up.
20 meters.
And.
3, 2, 1.
And it is fighting the wind. I'm really impressed. This is a small drone. Again, you see how much of an angle it's at? That's probably like a solid, 25 degrees. It is fighting the wind hard. So I'm a little nervous with the wind. I don't know how we're doing. There we go, it took off. Ah, it's not liking it. Oh wait, there we go. So I can do a little majestic spin for my Instagram, there we go. All right. And we're gonna land. With all that being said, I do want to talk about some of the things that I don't like. Personally, I am a big fan of being able to just use the USB-C and transfer the files directly to my computer. It just makes things easier for me to manage. However, when I did that, I did notice that the audio doesn't exactly sync up, and it actually makes a separate audio file from the video file. Now that's just me being nitpicky because that's how I like to work with things. The alternative is, and I think this is something that most people with this drone are going to be doing, is they're going to be transferring the files directly to their phone. And when they do that, the audio is integrated with those video files. So you basically just need to transfer those video files from your phone to your computer afterwards. Just one extra step. I would like to be able to just transfer it directly to my computer, but it's not that big of a deal. The other thing that I wasn't really big on was the microphone integration. Now, I'm using the DJI Mic 2. This is what I've been using for quite a while. And considering both of them are in the same ecosystem, I was hoping that this would just sync up with the drone, but that doesn't seem to be the case. What I've ended up having to do was use the microphone either built into the remote controller or into the phone, and then I have to sync it later with the microphone. So that is a little bit disappointing, and I was really hoping that I would be able to just use the mic directly to this and then transfer everything. Not the end of the world, but you know, if your phone doesn't pick up very well or you forget to hit the setting in the phone app, then you end up with these video files that don't have any audio, and that's a little bit of a pain. Hopefully in the future they will upgrade that, and DJI, if you're listening, integrate the microphone. It just makes sense. I don't know how hard that would be, but I really hope you end up doing it. Especially because when I do these quick shots, I end up not having any audio, and that's kind of something I would personally like. Aside from that, those are really my only two major complaints about this drone. One thing that I have heard people complain about with the original Neo was that it was really noisy, and hate to break it to you, but this one's not doing a whole lot better. It is still noisy, so if you're trying to be kind of stealthy, you're out of luck on this one. Maybe the future will have something quieter. Aside from that, those are really my only two major complaints about the drone. I do want to try out this transmitter. Apparently it does work up to 10 kilometers. I haven't actually made an account with my DJI app on this phone, or at least I haven't logged into it, so I haven't been able to test out the range of this. I was able to get it up to an altitude of 50 meters, and then I was able to get it 50 meters away from me. I should be able to get it further once I actually log into the app. I've just been kind of busy, but I think if I do a future video on this drone, I may do that. Now for pricing and availability. Like I said, I picked this up in China. I grabbed this for 2,499 won. That was with three batteries, a remote, and this transmitter right here. So that comes out to about $350. The price is probably gonna be a little bit more wherever you purchase it because, you know, I got this from China. This is a Chinese company, so we would expect that it would be cheaper there. This will be releasing in the European Union and the UK on November 13th. I don't know the exact date for other regions. I believe it's gonna be the same release date here in South Korea and then over in Japan. As of right now, there is no planned US release date, or at least I don't think that an official release date has been announced. For those of you who are aware, DJI is currently awaiting an audit from the US government. If that audit isn't completed by December 23rd, then DJI products will no longer be sold in the US. Which also makes it a little bit difficult if you have DJI Care and you need to get it repaired, then you're going to have to ship it out to wherever you purchased it from. In my case, I would have to ship this back to China, which is a little bit of a pain, but not the biggest problem, I guess. Not awesome, but not the end of the world. So hopefully, the US gets a audit done before December 23rd. I wouldn't hold my breath on that, but we can keep our fingers crossed and get that sorted out. And I'm sorry for you guys. Maybe go purchase it in Canada and then just use a VPN if you wanna update the firmware, or ship it over there if you wanna get it fixed. I'm really sorry, guys. I know that kind of sucks, but welcome to the world of fun. Overall, I am extremely happy with this drone. It is really durable. It's a lot of fun. It's easy to use. I love the fact that I can just launch it off my palm with a button and do quick shots. I would recommend picking this up if you are into making travel content videos, or you just want to have a fun little durable drone. I would even be comfortable with letting my little five-year-old nephew play with this. I wouldn't be too worried about it. So that's always a nice thing. If you want to see more content like this, let me know. I would love to do more of this. I wasn't really sure if this aligns with the stuff that I've been doing. I know I do a lot of travel content, and this kind of works with that because you know, it's gear that I would use for making travel videos, but I would like to do some other tech reviews and drone reviews and all that thing. So let me know. Give me a like and subscribe. That always tells me that you like this kind of video, and it encourages me to make more. And I will probably have the Always Sunny in Philadelphia filming locations video for season 4 out in the next week or two. I just got married and I've been really busy with some travel and some other things going on, but that's all filmed. I've started editing it. I just haven't finished it up, and I wanted to get this video out soon. But until next time, take care. We'll see you around.
Wow. Neo 2?
Yeah.
Damn. 이거 보게 될 줄이야. 나도 보는 거.
So yeah.
Yeah, it's very nice.
여기하고 여기가 두 개가 달려 있어.
Yeah, yeah.
말고 뭐예요? 센서.
Yep.
센서라고.
Yeah, yeah. I think 2.2-inch sensor.
Sensor.
Yeah, yeah. So bigger.
조금 더 보강이 된 거예요, 이게.
Bigger sensor and f-stop is I think 2.2.
그 네오가 저기 센서가 없었는데 얘는 센서를 앞에 전면에
그래서 이제 그 전면에 이제 부딪힌 위험도 없고.
Let's see how the auto home. Yeah, yeah, 감사합니다. Do you mind if I? Is it okay?
Yeah, it's
okay. Okay,
okay. Is that we have to go out? Because it's 4 p.m.
Oh, it's, yeah. Oh, okay. Ah.